Katie, have you had a good day?
Yeah. Joe took me to the swings.
To the swings?
How about you?
Yeah, you know up in the mountains in the wintertime they play parlour games? I think this time he bought a few.
You got a posting?
Yeah, Thompson's Landing.
Well, what's it like?
Well, it's pretty quiet, they say. It's a moose, Katie.
They're a bit like the deer we get at home.
Yeah, this one thinks he owns the road. Well, come on! Right.
Nick.
That's all right. I've been trained for this. Right, come on, old girl. Move it. We're going to push off. Go, go. Go, move it. Push off.
You can find it away.
Yes.
I didn't know you spoke moose.
I told you I've been trained for this.
Oh, so while we sat for 3 months in that flat in Calgary, you were off training to be an animal linguist.
Well, after 6 years of working with the auction, it's a piece of cake.
Pink pajamas.
It should be just around the next corner.
We said that half an hour ago.
Give me that map again. We must have gone wrong somewhere.
Can't be it, can it, Nick?
Well, according to this, the first place we come to is Thompson's Landing.
But look at it, Nick. It's a ruin.
There's someone over there.
Where?
Over there, look. I'll go and ask him. Maybe we took the wrong road. Hello there. Excuse me. Can you tell me the way to Thompson's Landing? Well, this isn't it, is it?
Straight ahead. There's only one road.
All right, thanks.
What's he going there for? Nobody goes there.
Hey, no, I'm the new policeman, Nick Rowan.
Name's Frank. My son is Ben, and his cousin Mo.
Well, nice to meet you, and thanks for your help.
Now this is a bit more like it.
Where's the horse?
What horse?
I keep telling you, love, Daddy isn't going to have a horse.
Then why is he a mountain?
It's a bit complicated, sweetheart.
Can I build a snowman?
Of course you can. A bit later, we're going to explore first.
Is this good enough for you, Mrs. Rowan?
It's great.
I don't think anyone's lived here for a while.
Nothing that a good lick of paint won't cure. Ooh, and a fire.
It looks like someone's laid one for us. Right, I'll get the bags. Hey, don't you go wandering off.
I bet there's no hot water, Nick.
Hey?
Daddy, Daddy, come and see.
What's she up to? What is it?
I can see the water.
Oh, it's amazing, isn't it?
It's beautiful. Look at that. Beautiful. I have to take a skating, I think. Sweetheart.
Hey, hey.
How are you?
Are you doing okay there? Yeah?
Rowan? Sergeant Hudakoff, subdivision commander in Rutherford. Thought I'd come over and show you a few things to look out for and see how you're settling in, of course.
Yeah, we've only just arrived. This is my wife, Jo, and Katie, my daughter.
How do you do, ma'am? Katie?
Nice to meet you. Come on, Katie, let's see if we can get the range going. Come on.
Well, Rowan, you'll report into Rutherford once a day by radio.
Is it far?
About 60 miles by road. Only 10 if you can cross the lake. The boat saves time. Come in twice a week, pick up any divisional orders, all that stuff. The phones tend to go down after a snowfall, so don't rely on them. You had an independent posting before?
Yeah, I'm used to it.
You better be. Once winter sets in, you'll be pretty much on your own.
It's not working, Katie.
Quarters suit you, ma'am.
Oh, yes. They're very spacious.
Well, they should be. We've always had a two-man detachment posted up here before, but if division thinks one's enough, we'll have to go along with that. You ready, Rowan?
Yeah. I'll get you my uniform on.
Looks like you need a hand with that range. Best thing to get it going is pine cones. Where's your weapon?
Well, I didn't think I'd need it.
Don't start off with any fancy foreign ideas, Rowan. You're in uniform. That includes your sidearm. Don't go back for it now. We don't have time. There's only one person who'll give you trouble on a regular basis.
Who's that?
Ma Gibson.
There we go.
Whenever there's trouble, you can be pretty certain that she's at the bottom of it somewhere.
Looks almost familiar. What's she do?
More like what doesn't she do. Old age seems to be slowing her down, just not fast enough. She was spotted last week up in the national park, so your first task is to find out what scheme she's hatching up there and stomp on it.
She live on her own?
She does now. Buried two husbands. Last one just disappeared. My guess is she lost her temper and ate him with hash browns. We just can't prove anything.
Has she got a record?
The last two men up here spent 3 years trying, so if you can pin anything on her, you'll be doing okay. Haven't had an English constable in this division before. Still, if you get into trouble, we'll come and pull you out. Keep your eye on them.
Well, Frank and his son.
You already know them.
Gave me directions.
It's about the last thing they'll give you that's not trouble. They live up that way. There's a native settlement there.
What do they do?
Not much, far as I can see. Of course, there's not much for them to do around here. Jerry's Bar. That's where all the trouble starts. Jerry keeps a lid on it, usually. Except when the boys come in from the logging camp. Spend their wages. Pick a fight with the natives.
How'd you handle it?
That's up to you. But I'd say the best thing to do is wave your gun at them and hope they're not too drunk to see what it is. If things get bad, Jerry's got a shotgun under the bar. That usually settles things down.
And what happens if it doesn't, and I have to arrest someone?
Call us, and we'll send support.
How'd you get on?
Oh, all seems fairly straightforward.
And then you and the sergeant.
Well, he doesn't like the Brits much. He doesn't seem to like anybody much, so at least he's consistent.
Oh, charming. I think you might have another Sergeant Blaketon on your hands.
Well, this one's a bit bigger.
Yeah, everything's a bit bigger here. Oh, well, it'll be more homey when the rest of our stuff arrives. How'd you like a nice hot cup of tea?
Sounds like a good idea. Hudakov gave me these. Better put them in the office.
That's the one thing I don't like so far.
We only have to open this up to count them. Oh, thank you. So this is my new patch. About the size of North Yorkshire, I reckon.
I know they said it was going to be isolated, but I didn't think it would be quite so...
What?
I don't know, empty.
It's all going to be all right. We'll get to know the people in time. Good morning. Need a hand?
I can manage perfectly well.
I'm the new constable, Nick Rowan.
Very polite, huh? A few weeks of Hudakov, you'll be humming a different tune. Anything happens, it's go round the Gibson place, give her hell. Just you wait.
We'll keep an open mind on that, shall we?
Well, I guess you can't be worse than the last lot.
Some more jam on that.
No.
Yeah. Some more tea.
Hi there. I'm Mrs. Roberts.
Can I help you?
Oh, well, I'm Mrs. Roberts. I clean twice a week.
Oh, I see. I'm sorry. I didn't realize.
Didn't Sergeant Hudakov tell you?
No. No, he didn't.
Isn't that just typical? Now, where are you from?
Yorkshire. In England?
Oh, never mind. Folks will get used to you just the same. Is the constable in?
No, he's out taking a look around.
Oh, I'll start in the office then. Oh, hello there. What's your name, sweetheart?
Katie.
Oh, that's a lovely name.
Come on, let's finish our tears.
Hey, Frank. How you doing?
Saw you with Sergeant Hudakov yesterday.
Yeah, just showing the uniform.
You've come a long way to be a policeman.
Well, I used to be a policeman before. In a place much like this. Only the mountains were a bit smaller.
And you didn't have natives there?
Yeah. Yorkshiremen.
They give you trouble?
Some of them.
You arrest them?
If I had to. Yeah, I try to sort things out myself. It's a small place. Everyone has to live together.
Sounds okay.
We never had a lady living here before. It's always been two men. And boy, do they need a lot of clearing up after.
I can imagine. But then we've got Katie.
Oh, she's so sweet. Oh, how long have you been married?
Less than a year.
Oh, really? Well.
Oh, Katie's Nick's daughter, not mine. His first wife died.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, it's okay. It can be confusing.
When we got married, we decided to come out here and make a fresh start. Are there any children in the area?
No more than a dozen.
Any about Katie's age?
Not many. There's Cora Palmer, rents a room opposite Jerry's bar. Her boy must be rising 5. But they're not what you'd call a regular family. You'd maybe not get along.
Well, how do you mean?
There's no husband. She arrived a few months back, and since then, her boy and her have just kept themselves to themselves.
Oh, well, maybe we'll call on them anyway, as we're all strangers.
You suit yourself. Now, if you want anything, anything at all, we're the first farm out on the back road. Feel free to drop in any time.
Thank you.
Well, Hudakoff told you the score, huh? Yeah, the Indians are kind of a fixture around here. But it's the Logan boys bringing the cash, and if I ban them, they'll just drive further, spend their money someplace else.
But it's the Logans that usually start the trouble.
Can be an Indian. I mean, some young blood comes in, takes offense at a comment. Of course, somebody's got to make the comment before the thing gets rolling. Hey, I pay you to push that, not lean on it.
The next time anything happens, give me a call before the trouble starts.
Yeah, well, I like to handle these things myself, you know?
Yeah, I heard. But we don't want any more shooting, or you and I might fall out. You know what I mean?
Sure.
Okay. Here we go. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome, Mrs. Rowan.
Oh, excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
Could you tell me where Mrs. Palmer lives?
Oh, just across the street, apartment upstairs. There's a door around the side.
Well, thank you.
Have a nice day.
I'm sure Mrs. Palmer was in there. I could hear her son playing.
Yeah, Mrs. Roberts says she's a bit quiet.
I think that's her way of saying that they don't approve of unmarried mothers around here.
RCMP, Thompson's Landing.
This is Frank.
Remember what you said to Jerry about calling before the trouble
starts? Well, I'm calling.
Right, I'm on my way. I'll see you in a minute. Sit down, Ben. Ben, sit down or you'll end up in a cell. And you. Evening, Jerry. Is there a problem?
No problem. Not yet.
Usually happens nearer to closing time. Hey, Jerry?
I thought you were going to call me if something happened.
I told you I can handle this.
And I told you that's not good enough.
Two beers, Jerry.
So you're the new law around here, are you?
That's right.
Well, what do you know? Our cop's a Brit. What do you say, boys? We buy him a beer?
No, thanks. Now I'm on duty.
If you're on duty, how come you aren't wearing a gun?
Well, there's not much point wearing a gun unless you're going to shoot someone.
Well, if you aren't drinking, I figure you're in the wrong place. What do you think?
Well, I think you and your friends have had enough.
You going to make us leave?
Seems reasonable.
Reasonable? You hear that, boys? He's so polite. Now, I'll tell you what. You turn around and head out that door and there won't be no fuss. Because you're the one making the fuss. Right, boys?
Yeah.
Now you go back to your camp now, or I'll stop being so reasonable, okay?
Guess he's right.
All right, Jerry.
Sure, yeah. Just saved a bit of sweeping up, I guess.
Will you call me sooner next time, all right?
Sure, sure thing.
Everything okay?
Yeah. Yeah, fine.
So what was the problem?
Oh, nothing you haven't seen before. Just like home, really.
I'm not so sure.
Why, what?
We've got a visitor. Take a look out the window. Finish reading the riot act to the locals. Perhaps you could sort him out.
No, not me. I'm off duty.
Since when?
Since I just saw him.
I thought bears were supposed to be hibernating.
Well, you go and tell him. Not yet, Sarge.
I told you, I want you to get on her back.
I want some fast answers, Rowan.
Okay, Sarge.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Are you Mrs. Palmer?
Yes, I'm Joanna Rowan. This is Katie. We just moved into the police station.
Your husband's the new constable.
That's right. Look, we heard that you had a little boy. I was wondering if he wanted to come and play with Katie sometime.
He's very shy.
Well, there are so few children around. It seems a shame not to get together.
Yes, maybe sometime. I'm sorry, I have to go.
Constable.
Frank. Well, thanks for your help last night.
Thank you. What brings you up here?
Well, I need some advice. Did you spend much time in the national park?
Why? Hunting is illegal, so we wouldn't hunt there.
Yeah, I know. Well, I just want to take a look around. See what's going on.
Like what?
Well, you tell me. I'm interested in a truck that's been seen driving around there recently.
Park's people blasted a few roads. Trucks leave tracks.
I suppose so.
Early morning's the best time.
Right, now, you take that, Katie. You start at the bottom, and I'll start at the top, and we'll see if we can meet in the middle. Oh, that's very good. Well done, you. Careful you don't get it on your clothes. You did a very good job. We'll have it done by the time Daddy gets home, won't we?
Yeah.
I'll be so pleased.
Hang on a minute.
Hurry!
Hey. Hurry!
Hang on a minute!
Travis, you okay? You okay?
What happened?
The car came out of the woods. Travis tried to swerve and we went into a skid. He's hurt pretty bad.
Travis, can you hear me?
Oh, my arm. My shoulder.
You will sit tight. I've called an ambulance. Don't try and move, okay?
And my gut still hurts.
You're gonna be all right. Sit tight.
Is he gonna be all right?
Well, he smashed his arm up a bit and lost some blood, but he should be okay.
It's a bit worrying being so far away from the nearest doctor.
Well, he comes round twice a week, apparently. You're allowed to be a bit peaky on Mondays and Thursdays. Did you register Katie at the school?
Yeah.
And?
It was nice.
You know what I mean?
They're fully staffed. Look, don't worry, Nick. I said at home my main priority is us. You, me and Katie.
You'll still need something eventually.
Well, it'll come when I'm ready for it. Well, I finally met the mysterious Cora Palmer.
What's she like?
Evasive.
How do you mean?
I don't know, there's just something odd about her. I mean, I still haven't seen her son. Do you think there could be something wrong with him?
Well, like she's got him locked in a cupboard or something. You probably just missed him.
Maybe. What are you doing?
I've got an early start in the morning.
Well, you better make sure you get some sleep then, haven't you?
Well, don't you like my new uniform?
Mm.
now?
Morning, Mrs. Gibson.
I know it is. What do you want?
I just wonder what you've been doing up in the park.
None of your business.
Well, if it's against park regulations, that could make it my business.
Just taking a ride. Nothing illegal about that. So you've no call to be picking on innocent people.
Well, then you don't mind if I take a look in the back of your truck?
You got a warrant?
No. I don't need one if you're innocent.
Argumentative, aren't you? Satisfied? Next time, maybe you think twice before harassing folk going about their business. It's not right. I'm nearly an old age pensioner.
Well, thank you very much. You've been most cooperative.
Nick, just in time to lend a hand.
I thought this lot wasn't coming till next week.
Well, they wanted to get them here before the weather closes in. Oh, Mrs. Roberts took Katie to the farm for the day. She wasn't about to get crushed by the furniture. She was into every crate looking for Molly the dolly. I'll pick her up at tea time.
Right, where do you want me to start?
Morning, ma'am. Rowan? Good work with the loggers yesterday. I hear they're both okay. There was some sort of incident at Jerry's bar the other night.
Someone complained?
No. As a matter of fact, it's hard to find anyone who'll tell me just what happened.
Well, there's not much to say, really. Some of the boys got a bit rowdy. I said maybe they had enough, and then they left.
Is that all?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, if it's that easy, maybe you'd oblige us by getting on this Gibson case.
Well, I don't think there is a case, Sarge.
Trust me, Rowan. There's a case there somewhere.
Evening, Ma. We got a good haul for you today.
Well, don't stand around there shooting the breeze. Get it on here.
Well, what's biting you?
I got stopped by the mounters this morning.
I thought there weren't no cops around here.
Well, there is now. New guy. Pretty smart, too. Come on, come on, get it on.
Well, we'll be gone in a few days. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, easy enough for you to say. Ain't you having to drive in and out of here all the time?
You're getting your cut.
And I'm carrying the can?
Well, look, if you're that worried about it, we'll fix it.
That's right.
Jim Roberts, your little girl's inside.
Oh, I hope she hasn't caused you too much trouble.
Oh, no, not at all. She's helped with the baking, she helped feed the chickens, she helped milk the goats, and then she cut loose and went and fed the chickens again.
Sounds like she's been having fun.
Yeah. She was pretty keen to sweep out the stables, too, but I wouldn't let her. The horses get a bit restless after I bring them in for the winter.
Well, how many have you got?
Six. Do you ride, Mrs. Rowan?
Oh, whenever I can get the chance.
You know, you'd be doing me a big favor if you'd come over and take one of them out once in a while. Exercise is good for them.
I might just take you up on that.
Anytime, you just ask. Now, we better get inside here and find your little girl.
Okay.
There you go.
Thank you.
Oh, look who's here. And we were going to clean you up before she came.
Jojo fed the chickens.
So I hear, more than once. Have you been a good girl? She's been perfect.
Can I come tomorrow?
Oh, of course you can, sweetheart.
Well, I think that would be a bit much.
Oh, she's always welcome. This place has been too quiet since ours went off to college. Now, you can have some of those cookies we made earlier, and I'll put them in a bag for you.
Well, that's really kind.
Oh, not at all. That's why we made so many. Now, where did I put those bags?
Same place you always do, in the cupboard.
Oh, all right.
Now, you stop by any time tomorrow morning. We'll be right here.
You're shoveling snow, I think.
You put on your nice warm coat. Good girl. And I'm going to go and get the car all nice and warmed up for you. So you sit here and wait for me. There you are. You can play with Dolly. All right, I'll be back in a minute. All right, my love.
You having a problem, Nick?
Won't start.
We can give you a lift.
Well, let me have a look first.
Can you give us a push?
Well, there's not much point. Someone's taken both distributor caps.
What?
And someone doesn't want me driving around for a while.
Well, there was a man hanging around here when I brought Katie back last night.
Did you get a good look at him?
Not really. What, should we call a garage?
Well, the lines are down. I'll radio into Rutherford, and then we'll all better take a walk down to the Roberts.
What for?
Well, if someone doesn't want me out and about, that's where I should be.
Let's hurry up before they leave. We'll wave goodbye.
You be a good girl, sweetheart.
Yes. Bye-bye, darling. Be good.
Bye-bye now.
Be bye-bye. Careful. Okay, come on. Let's go and bake. Yeah, we've got a lot to do.
Where are we going?
Well, I thought I'd show you some of my new patch. I've got to do a bit of work on the way.
Like what?
Interviewing a witness.
Oh, sounds interesting. Who's the witness?
You. I want you to tell me everything about that man you saw last night.
Well, I hardly ever saw him.
Oh, this is great, isn't it?
Yeah. It'll be good when Katie's old enough to ride a horse so we can bring her up here.
Yeah, she'll love it.
Come on.
It's a funny time of year to be camping. Those tracks are new.
Well, it could be poachers.
Yeah. Good morning. You been for one of your rides again?
What have I have?
Let's take a look in the back, shall we?
Oh.
Where did you find these?
I'm thinking about it.
Well, while you're thinking, let's take a ride back to your place, eh? Joe, can you take those back to the Roberts place?
Yeah, of course I can. See you later.
I'll drive. And, by the way, you're under arrest.
Yeah, I've only got four of them gears and I'd like to keep them.
Well, if you can find them, you're welcome to them.
his vehicle been tested recently?
Oh. I'm looking for Frank.
You found him?
I'm Joanna Rowan, Nick's wife.
That's so.
My husband says that you've been having a problem sending your children to school.
We don't care for the one in the village.
If you didn't want to send them there, you could start one here a few mornings a week.
We don't have a teacher.
Well, I could help you. I'm a teacher.
This way.
You ain't shutting me up in there.
Just watch me.
I want to talk to my lawyer.
Well, there's the phone.
Well, the lines are down.
Then you'll have to shout very loud. Come on.
Oh, you. You're not no right to do this.
Mrs. Gibson, you seem to be forgetting that you're under arrest. I have every right. Good night.
Good night. Oh, Lordy. Right. Lock me up in his cell. Is anybody there? What time does this place wake up? Hey! Hey!
There's a funny lady downstairs making lots of noise.
It's all right.
What's going on?
Different worry about it, wasn't he?
We have lights in this country
now!
Morning.
Oh, about time. I want animals to feed. Now, am I getting out of here or do I have to get my lawyer?
Well, that depends on you, really. If you don't like sugar, don't stir it.
What's this?
Tea.
We have coffee in this country. What do you mean? Getting out of here depends on me.
Well, I'm going to have to write a report on what's in the back of your truck.
Oh.
Now, you can spin me some story about finding it on the side of the road, or you can tell me the truth. Like how many men you're supplying in the national park.
Don't know what you're talking about.
Don't mess me about. I need to know who they are and where you meet them.
Why should I?
Either you help me, or I hand you over to Hudakov. He'll throw the book at you.
Oh. Oh, okay. There are two of them. I take them supplies and I pick up their kill.
Where?
The turning point, about 10 miles off the track, from the entrance.
And then what do you do with it?
The butchers, Forest Creek. Can I go?
I should finish your tea first.
Where are the keys of my truck?
Oh, well, there's one more condition. I might need to borrow it for a while.
Well, how am I going to get home?
Well, you're driving, mate.
Well, I ain't no taxi driver.
Well, then you'll have to walk. Rutherford Detachment, this is Thompson's Landing, over.
Yeah, this is Hudakov. What's up, Ron?
Can you send transport for two prisoners?
Prisoners? What the hell's going on over there?
I've got a couple of trappers up in the national park.
I'm going to bring them in.
I'm coming over. Out.
If he's coming over, I'm coming with you.
Ma, act natural. What the hell?
Hey, Ma. How come you ain't got rid of this load yet?
Afraid you boys had better talk to him.
Drop the guns. Put that in the truck. Now cuff yourselves together, you're under arrest. Right, now get in.
There's game in there.
Well, you killed it. You can travel with it. Get in. Guess where?
I told you I ain't no taxi driver. And I ain't driving no paddy wagon either.
I should drive if I were you. Hey! Put down!
Chocolate.
Hi there, what can I do for you?
Yeah, I'll have a carton of cigarettes.
Okay.
That does do. I've got a long journey, so get us some sweets.
How about these?
Yeah. Kids love sweets.
Can you run with me? Okay, let's go. Let's run.
Get him, Ron.
In the back.
Let's have a look.
Coming at you, Gap.
Well, well. Dwight and Martin, I might have guessed it.
You know these two?
Yeah, we ran him out of the area last year. Couldn't get any evidence to prosecute. Looks like you managed it, though. Corporal McClinchy, take these two and move that game into your car.
Damn. I only cleaned it out this morning.
Well, when you get back to Rutherford, you'll have to clean it out again.
Come on now. You heard the sergeant.
Well, how are we supposed to haul these carcasses with cuffs on?
You still got two hands each, don't you?
So what about her?
Well, they were running the kill to a butcher's in Forest Creek.
Forest Creek, eh? We'll stop and pick him up on the way back. You haven't charged her.
We've also got Martin for malicious damage to a police car.
Right.
When do I get paid?
What for?
Hiring my truck, of course.
If I had anything to do with it, you'd be back there shifting that game before coming back to a cell in Rutherford. So my advice to you is wait till they're through, then beat it. Consider yourself darn lucky.
Typical. Person does their civic duty or they get abuse.
You're trying my patience, Gibson, more than usual.
Help me, please.
Yes, ma'am?
We're in terrible danger.
You better come inside.
It's my husband. I've just seen him in the ice cream store.
And why would you be in danger from your husband?
Because I left him. And I took our son, Bobby. And I never thought he'd find us here.
What's his name?
Brian Palmer. Corporal Brian Palmer. He's with the British Army. I met him when I was working in England. He was so nice at first, and then he just turned violent. And 2 years ago, I just left. And I never thought he'd find us.
And you're sure it was him you saw in the ice cream store?
Yes, of course I am.
No chance it could have been a mistake.
No. Look, I know it was him. I'm telling you, he's here. I saw him.
There is someone living up in the National Park. Saw a campsite out there.
Could have been those two poachers.
Well, they didn't have a vehicle. This person does.
I'll go back to Rutherford and make a few inquiries. Tracing him through the army should be pretty simple. Then we can put your mind at ease. Now, why don't you let Constable Rowan take you and the boy home?
The sergeant's right, Mrs. Palmer. We'll find out where your husband is pretty quickly.
Yeah, how long is that going to take? He could have left the army or deserted. He's a very violent man. You're just going to wait for something to happen?
No, we're going to do all we can to make sure nothing happens. Jerry, Frank. I need your help.
What's up?
Cora Palmer. The lady who lived just across the street. Her and her son may be in danger.
How can we help?
Well, there's a man living rough in the national park. Do you know anything about him?
We know he's there. No one's seen him. But we've seen tracks, heard a car.
Well, I need to find him fast.
There's not enough of us. Not for a search like that.
Well, if you can watch the slopes on this side, the tracks of them out just for a day or so, keep a watch on the Palmer house. If you see anyone hanging around,
Jerry,
anything unusual, let
beer.
Me know immediately.
Sure. Okay.
So what brings you in here?
Buy you a beer?
No, thanks, no. Are you prepared to give me some help?
Depends what you want us to do.
I want to borrow some trucks.
Been, Rowan.
Making arrangements, Sarge. What's happened?
Seems the lady could be right. Corporal Palmer went AWOL from battle group exercises in Chilliwack on the other side of the Rockies.
How long ago?
They're not sure. They send them out for weeks at a time in full kit. He could have been gone a couple of weeks.
Has he got any weapons?
Probably. I'll send him a clinchy straight back. In the meantime, you better check the gun cupboard and hope you won't be needing it.
Can you get that, Joe? What's up?
Father says the man is here. He saw the car near Palmer's house.
Right, let's go. Joe, can you radio into Rutherford and tell them that Palmer's been seen in town? And lock the doors. Don't let them to anyone. Okay?
Well, be careful.
So have you seen anything yet?
Don't go.
Some guy just bust out of the house and drove off. Big Mo tried to stop him, he got shot at.
He's taken him. Brian has taken Bobby.
Yeah, which way did he go? Which way did he
towards
go?
Towards the settlement.
But we'll find him. Wait, stand clear, stand clear.
Here he goes. Let's go. Let's go.
McKinsey, Palmer's taken the boy. I think he's heading towards the settlement. Try and cut him off at the slip road. I'll be right behind you. Son, get down and stay down, okay?
Tree.
I'll go around back.
Mama, you don't want your son to get hurt, do you?
This used to be a quiet place, you know?
Come on, let's get back.
Just open the door!
What name?
I said police, goddammit!
I just got to go and get the key! Okay, now, Katie, don't be afraid. You come with me. Good girl, now don't be afraid.
If you're going to go in somewhere. Up.
Come on, darling.
A bit parky out here. Especially with a kid. Let's go inside. Inside.
Where's Cora, Jerry?
She's inside. Ma's taking care of her.
Come on, Bobby. In you go. Come on.
Okay, people. Who actually saw what happened? Like, who was actually there and didn't hear it from their cousin's brother-in-law? Anyone?
You
know? Oh, my God, Bobby. Oh, God.
He's okay. Your husband took off, Mrs. Palmer. We'll take you both up to the station. You'll be safe there.
Okay.
McGlinchey, we'll get him out to the police station.
Sure.
You all right, man?
Sure. Palmer's here. Drop the gun!
I want to talk to Rowan.
I'm here.
You got my son. I got your family. Just give me my son.
He's back with his mother.
Well, I want him here.
Well, McGlinchey will have to go back for him.
Well, do it.
Joe!
Shut up!
You let my family go, Palmer. You want a hostage, you take me. Let's talk about it.
There's nothing to talk about.
Look, I'm coming over, okay? You let me in, and McGlinchey will go back for Bobby. Otherwise, no deal.
Do it. Do it now.
Inside.
Slowly.
You're right, Joe.
Shut up! Cut off. Hands where I can see him. Turn around.
The deal was you'd let my family go.
I'll get my son back. They were there, weren't they? Colin Bobby, they were bloody there. Right. All of you round the back. You better pray you might bring some back. Better pray! Right, Rowan, in the cell. Get in the cell. Get in there! Hey, not you. Give him the kid.
Oh, she's terrified.
Give him the kid! Okay, you stay out here. Okay, give me your cuffs. Give me your cuffs!
He's got Rowan and his family hostage. Can you guys take care of Cora and the kid? I've got to get back there.
Sure. Come on, honey. Let's get you two inside before you catch your death.
Is a constable in real trouble?
And his family.
Well, we'll come with you. We know a way in. Tell me something.
What?
How long you planned this?
I don't know. Weeks. Since we've been sent out here for the exercise. Blokes get lost on maneuvers all the time. Nobody even noticed I'd gone. Still, I never really thought I'd do it.
Well, it's not too late. You don't have to go through with this.
Oh, yeah. You're a dad. How'd you feel if you'd never seen your kid for years?
I don't know.
Yeah. I could have shot you out there.
You might have hurt Bobby.
That's why I let you go.
Whereabouts you from?
Hackney Marshes.
Do you know the Lansdowne in Clapton Road?
I used to drink there.
So did I.
Funny that, isn't it? Come all this way and ran into another East End boy.
Well, how do you think you're going to get back there?
What, the Lansdowne or England?
Well, either. It hasn't worked, Palmer. You carry on, you could lose Bobby forever.
I'll work something out.
That you're a decent man. You took a chance when you stopped to tell me about that accident.
Yeah, well, people got hurt. I couldn't just leave them.
You've got a jacket in now. The only person who's going to get hurt is you. And then Bobby won't have a father.
Keys to the cuffs. Keys!
Palmer! Corporal Palmer! We've got the boy safe! Now come out with your hands up!
Tara, shall we mean business?
At! Corporal Palmer! Drop the gun!
Now you listen to me! If I don't get my boy back, I'll kill them all.
You know I can't do that, Palmer.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Yes, you can. All you gotta do is just go fetch Bobby and bring him here.
Constable, we're going to get you out the same way Mo got out.
I need more time.
Don't talk to me about time. You got 10 minutes. Now, if you haven't got my boy back here in 10 minutes,
I can't take responsibility for what happens next!
I'll have to wait for my superior!
Did you hear me?
Look, I don't have the authority.
Authority?
That's enough talking, just do it!
Do it!
Frank, can you take Katie back to the village?
Hugh.
You go with Frank, sweetheart. I'll see you in a minute.
Leo.
You too. Boathouse. Okay, come, come, come.
Back inside!
Now! Go on!
Let me go, please.
You're my only hope now. Dad! McClinchy.
I've never seen so much trouble in my town before.
Wait in the car, I'll be right there. I can't do that, man. Not until I've seen the situation for myself.
But how long is that going to take? Please, you got to let me talk to him. I don't want to see anybody get killed.
Okay. Get in the car.
Oh, God.
But you keep out of sight when we get there.
Right, we've got to get Joe out.
How many ways are there into that place?
Where's the front door? The back door, that's barricaded.
You can't go in the front.
Yeah, there's another way. You ready?
I think we should both go in.
She's my wife. You got some matches? Come on, come on.
Rudikov's not gonna like this.
Rudikov's not here. Hey, now give me 2 minutes to get into position, all right? You better give me a 38. Come on. Mo, Mo.
Why didn't you get out as well?
Came back for you.
We're both holding guns.
To get you out, I mean.
It's too late for that.
It's not too late. You haven't killed anyone.
What about that engine I shot at?
No, he's all right. Just a bit shaken up. I know you didn't mean this to happen. You can put a stop to this now.
Corporal Palmer, the house is surrounded. Come out now. Last chance, Palmer, come out now.
But they're not going to mess about. If I wasn't there, the chances are they'd shoot you.
Why'd you stay?
I've arrested a lot of people over the years, and none of them got shot. Just because I'm over here, I don't see why I should start now.
You do understand, don't you? What it's like to be kept away from your kid.
I think I can understand what you're going through. I've lost someone. But this isn't the way.
Can you help me? Sort this out.
Yeah, I can try.
Help me see Bobby again.
Sarge. Get the cuffs on him and get him in the car.
How the hell do you do that, Rowan?
Are you okay?
Yeah, how about you?
Yeah, I'm fine. Where's Katie?
Right here.
Katie, thanks, Frank.
Oh, anytime.
I'll need that report, Rowan.
Yeah, sure.
No rush. Day after tomorrow, I'll be fine. Glad to see you and your family are okay, Mrs. Rowan. Your husband did okay. For a Brit.
Thank you, Sergeant.
Good job, Patricia.
Well, I reckon I owe you guys.
We'll fix the door.
Oh, I'll make some coffee.
Any chance of a cup of tea?
We drink coffee in this country, don't we, Katie?
Yeah.
Come on, guys.
I'm your new village copper.
No!
Never fallen off the bike yet. I need to touch some wood. There's some heather that might do.
Ow!
the robbery last night. It's him. I told you not to come.
No,
I really
Nick,
thought you weren't going to come.
The stick.
Now listen, listen, you've got nothing to worry about if you're not in possession of any drugs.
I'm clean.
Now if you are, I have to know right now.
I'm clean.
You better pack your bags. If you're going, I'm staying. Thank you very much.
The crime wave in Aidensfield is worse than New York, I think, now.
Shout out louder than that.
Alex.
Oh, Nick!
I really think we should get you over to casualty.
I told you, Kate, the helmet took the force of most of it.
Yeah, but you could still have concussion.
Well, if I have, there's a doctor in the house, isn't there?
Aye, Inspector Murchison is due to arrive sometime this morning.
So what's he like, then?
Well, you tell me, lad.
Well, whoever it is, he's got to be an improvement on the last one.
That's enough of that out of you, Bellamy.
Sergeant Blaketon?
It is.
Inspector Murchison. I'm the new subdivisional inspector at Whitby.
What's happening between us?
I don't know. We just don't seem to be on the same wavelength anymore.
Yeah, well, it's you that's changed. What started off as a part-time partnership with you and James has suddenly become a full-time commitment. Isn't Radcliffe feeding you properly?
Oh, don't be silly.
I'm just concerned, that's all.
I know, I'm sorry.
That's all right, isn't it?
Of course.
Right. I'll see you then.
Nick, I'm pregnant.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Oh, you got it. Aren't you coming in
then? Hello, Sarah Rowan. Is that wrong with Sarah?
No, it's me. I've got leukemia.
Oh. Hey. You just had our baby. Kate. Come here. Yeah. I'm sick of the spare bed. So, if Madam doesn't object, I think I'll sleep in my own bed for a change. Come on. Give us a cuddle.
Casey Rowan. I thought you said most of the school would need to be done.
Fortunately, the bulk of them have already been vaccinated, thanks to the local GP. It's a pity there aren't more doctors like her around.
Yeah, isn't it?
Hello.
Oh, hello. You might have said the other day, I felt such a fool afterwards.
Why?
Because it was your wife I was talking about, when I was going on about our late local GP.
Yeah, well, I couldn't bring myself to somehow, sorry.
She's the new school teacher in the village. And, he has to help out, it seems, with lots of her... lots of children from her class. And, yes, I suppose... I think instantly attracted is a... is what it is. It's instant attraction, yeah.
Sorry, I'm not ready. Come in, I'll be 2 seconds. I don't think it was love at first sight, mainly because at that stage in Joe's life, it's not something that she's looking for.
Joan.
You said you had no choice.
Where's the job?
No, it isn't. This isn't about the job. It's about you.
Sorry?
You've been against this trip all along.
No, that's not true.
You didn't want anybody to know.
Look, we can rearrange the trip. I'll make it up to you.
No. It's over.
So, shall we give it another go?
Is that what you really want?
Yeah, it is. Really, it is.
Nick is a dream. He's really, this, because I do most of my scenes with him, it could have been a nightmare, but he's just lovely. He's so lovely to work with and so easy to work with.
Doesn't sound too good.
It's not funny, Nick. I'm going to kill Claw Greengrass. What am I supposed to do? Kill it with my bare hands?
Hang on.
What are you doing?
Well, if we do it now, we can cook it in time for a late supper.
No.
Bit of prune stuff.
Don't you dare touch it.
Roast potatoes.
I'm turning vegetarian and I'm going to keep her as a pet. Give me that.
All right, only if you say you'll marry me.
What?
Will you marry me?
Mum, Nick and I love one another.
I'm having nothing to do with this nonsense.
Fiona, please.
And neither are you.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the sight of God and in the face of this congregation to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony.
Well, I've known Nick ever since he first came to Yorkshire. And he's been the best village constable we could have had.
Oh, aye.
And the best mate I've ever had.
We've got some new people arriving.
Well, the new sergeant's coming this morning. This place is like a pigsty.
What's that, Marco?
Oh, blame him. He's been here 2 weeks and he hasn't washed a cup.
My brother, am I?
Oh, sorry. No time for social niceties. Stuff that lot on his desk and hopefully you won't notice it's 2 weeks behind.
I think he's guessed that.
What?
Hey.
Oh, stow me. Sergeant Rowan.
Come on, what is it?
Remember what we talked about?
Yeah.
Yeah, I sent off for some information.
What information?
Well, details of a job with the Canadian police.
Canada?
Look, you know I've not been happy in my new job. Made me start thinking about what I do want. I know I want to spend more time with you two. I just feel the three of us together could be a real adventure.
What will happen in the future, who knows? But you never know, really, do you?